local rivalry renews on the hardwood tonight for the second straight season after a break that lasted a decade. The Miami men's basketball team in action on the road tonight in Clifton to take on the UC Bearcats. Luke West Poley with you here pregame. I'll be joined by Zach Rengers for the call of this one between Miami and UC. RedHawks looking to get back to 500 on the year, coming off a win against Calumet on Sunday. RedHawks are 4-5 coming into this one for the UC Bearcats, 6-4 on the season, and one of the final few tune-ups before AAC play starts just prior to New Year's. UC 6-4 on the year, expecting a full house here from Fifth Third Arena. Should be a fun one. We're going to take a break, and when we come back, we'll have a conversation talking some Cincy hoops with the host of the Rebound Rundown, Mr. Paul Frischner. That'll all come when we return on our RedHawk Radio pregame. Stay with us. Back here at Fifth Third Arena, about 15 minutes away from Miami and UC here from Clifton, now joined by college basketball broadcaster, podcaster, in-arena host extraordinaire Paul Frischner, host of Not Too Picky, host of the Rebound Rundown as well. Paul, thank you for joining us here on our pregame.
Hey, absolutely, Luke. I really appreciate you having me on, and I'm excited for a good one here tonight. A couple of local teams. The color schemes, too. It'll be good color matchup here tonight, right?
Great color matchup, as always. You know, the game that took place over the weekend in the Crosstown Shootout is the one that obviously draws a lot of eyes, but really good, of course, to see a rivalry that has taken place a lot in terms of quantity, 149th meeting between these two teams, and to see that rekindled last year after a decade hiatus, and now here for the second straight year, and here in Cincinnati for the first time in a long time. Really good to see these two teams go at it once again.
You know, Luke, I think you hit the nail on the head. It's always good to see games like this continue to be played, and credit to Cincinnati for going up to Miami and playing that game there on campus. Of course, we saw the turnout at that game that came right down to the wire, and then of course Miami now here coming back down to Fifth Third Arena here on a midweek game. And like you said, just two area teams that have a lot of history. Of course, Miami has struggled over the recent years in their program, but you get first-year head coach Travis Steele's fresh off a tenure in the Big East. You have Cincinnati who's trying to fit some pieces together with second-year head coach Wes Miller. So there's a lot of dynamics at play in this game that I think are interesting. Of course, Cincinnati is a heavy favorite, but I think just overall there's a lot of little interesting side notes to this game here tonight.
Yeah, and certainly two teams in kind of similar positions, although they may be placed in different echelons of college basketball overall, that they're bringing in relatively new head coaches. Of course, Wes Miller in year two, Travis Steele in year one at Miami, but still trying to build those programs into powers. And good to see teams like this meet and continue those local rivalries like they will here tonight. So you talk a lot of Cincy hoops on the podcast, so I wanted to ask you some about that could potentially include these teams, could potentially not. I wanted to ask you, who do you think is your biggest surprise team through the early goings of the season on the positive side? We know the negative side of the teams you covered, if you want to count it as Louisville, but on the positive side of things, who do you think is the team that has kind of turned the most heads here in this early part of the season in Southwest Ohio?
Oh, well, when you look at the teams I cover here in the Rebound Rundown, I would say that Xavier and Kentucky are the two teams that I cover that have positioned themselves for an NCAA tournament berth right now. Cincinnati has some work to do, of course, as you look ahead toward the NCAA tournament. Not a whole lot of quality teams left on their resume. Two games against Memphis, two games against Houston. After we take a break here for the
national anthem? Yeah, we'll take a break here.
Okay.
All right, Paul, got a little cut off unbeknownst to us, but go right ahead back to what we were talking about earlier on.
Yeah, no doubt. We were talking about teams that you feel like maybe have had some positive impacts on the Cincinnati area so far, and I think two of those, like I mentioned, Xavier and Kentucky, positioned themselves for the NCAA tournament this year. Xavier, I think, has played better, especially offensively, than anybody really was anticipating that they would, and I know we're here in front of a crowd that's going to talk about Miami and Cincinnati. But Xavier's really positioned themselves well for the NCAA tournament. And the other thing that I think on the flip side that's been a disappointment has been Dayton, a team that was ranked in the preseason top 25. They have just completely fallen off. Of course, they've been riddled with injuries, especially to two of their best players. So they have just really fallen off the map here recently. They are a team that I'm looking at to see if they can kind of rebound here over the next month or two heading into the rest of the regular season. But Miami, they just have to clean things up. You know it as well. And you know it, I don't want to say as well, you know it much better than I do, having called these games. really just got to focus on the defensive end, right? You just got to improve things defensively, because regardless of how many shots you're making, if you can't stop anybody, it's going to be real tough to win games.
Absolutely. A Miami team that's had their fair share of issues through the early goings. They're 4-5, but two wins against some opponents that were not in the NCAA. Two NAIA teams on the schedule. They'll have a third later on their slate in St. Mary of the Woods, but a really, really tough three-game schedule coming up here for the RedHawks. Starting tonight against UC, they'll head to Bellarmine on Saturday to play against a team that is very unique in college basketball. You're very familiar with
yes.
as well. And then they're going to host a team that was in the tournament last year in Wright State back at Nalette next week. It's going to be a tough, tough test. These might be the three toughest games of the season in terms of a stretch right in a row for the RedHawks coming up.
Yeah, no doubt. And when you talk about Bellarmine, are you going to be at that game?
Yes,
are you guys going
yes.
down? Okay, so Bellarmine, for anybody listening that's going to be looking ahead to that game, they are a team where the ball never touches the court. They pass the ball incessantly. The ball just continues to move. The ball never hits the court. You can see possessions that might have three or four dribbles before a shot. They just continually move the ball. That is their MO offensively. And then you talk about Wright State, a team that lost a lot from last year and now is going to be in the bottom of the pack in the Horizon League. Wright State's had some trouble so far this season. I'm keeping an eye on Wright State and trying to see what they might do offensively as this year continues. But yeah, a couple of big tests now for Miami here in the next week or so.
Absolutely. Now on the Cincinnati side of things, you got LaSalle coming up this weekend, I should say. Then you got Detroit Mercy following the Christmas break. AAC play opens up. UC's final year in the AAC, projected third, I should say, in preseason. And just a lot to prove, I think, for this UC team. They got a lot of veterans. It's almost something that doesn't feel like they should have a lot of mystery surrounding their team. But it really does feel like this UC team has some untapped potential heading into their conference season this year.
Yeah, no doubt. And you look at Cincinnati, and they've had injuries, of course, to John Newman III, who was one of the team's best defenders. Also, a really debilitating injury to Rob Finnessy for point guard depth and also defensive depth, too. One of their best defenders, a transfer in from Indiana. So Cincinnati. The problem with Cincinnati is that they have squandered all of their high major opportunities in the non-conference schedule to really compete for an NCAA tournament berth. So when you look to set up and position yourself to make the NCAA tournament, to hear your name called on Selection Sunday, Cincinnati hasn't done that. They go out to Maui. The only team they beat in Maui was Louisville. And, of course, we all know what's
yep.
happened to Louisville. 0-9 right now. They could be looking at 0-10 tonight as home underdogs to Western Kentucky. So when you look at Cincinnati, you just think to yourself, you have to go into those four games in conference action. You got two against Memphis, two against Houston. You probably have to go 3-1 in those games to even be in the conversation, be even in that bubble conversation come March. But Cincinnati, under second-year head coach Wes Miller, they're still figuring things out. You expect them to hit the transfer portal hard before they head into the best conference in college basketball next year in the Big 12. That is going to be a massive step up.
Absolutely. The big games to circle on the schedule. There's a two-game set home and home with Houston. They will have them here on January the 8th in a nationally televised matchup. That's certainly going to be a key point for, like you said, a team that has struggled a little bit considering their non-conference opportunities if they want to make a run at the NCAA tournament. Well, we've had a nice preview of this one here. I want to thank Paul Frischner. Make sure to tune into his podcast where you get your podcasts every weekday.
Correct? Yeah, Rebound Rundown for everybody listening. The Rebound Rundown covers Miami, Wright State, Dayton, Xavier, Kentucky, Cincinnati, NKU. I think Louisville I mix in there too, the nine local teams. So yeah, it's a great way to just wake up on your morning commute, 10 minutes just to figure out what's going on, maybe what you missed the night before. But Luke, I just want to say you and Zach, you guys do a great job. I really appreciate you guys having me up here. And look, I'm looking down at your boards. You guys do a good job. I can't say enough. For your experience level and being on the younger side here at Miami, what this will pay off for you and your career, but for both of you. So congratulations to you, Luke, and everything you guys are doing up here in this broadcast. And look forward to it. Let's talk soon. Let's talk soon.
Definitely. Thank you very much, Paul Frischner, for joining us here on the Red Hawk Radio pregame. About 5 minutes away from tip between Miami and UC, the battle for the victory bell, so to speak, hits the hardwood between the Red Hawks and Bearcats. We'll take a break here on Red Hawk Radio. Tip-off is next. And with that, we welcome you inside Fifth Third Arena here in Cincinnati, Ohio. The Miami RedHawks set to take on the UC Bearcats here on a Wednesday night from Clifton here on RedHawk Radio. Luke West Poley joined by Zach Rengers alongside 149th meeting between the RedHawks and the Bearcats. Cincinnati has dominated this series as of late. RedHawks looking for their first win since the late 1980s. Should be a fun one in front of a pretty solid crowd, all things considered, given the break here at UC. Zach, looking down at the starting lineup for the RedHawks. Travis Steele's played with it a little bit, tried to maybe send some messages to his team, but here in this game tonight, safe to say it's the A5 starting on the floor for the RedHawks.
Yeah, and I think this is the starting five that Travis Steele has been looking for this whole year. Obviously, he gets Safford back, after he sustained that injury in the Evansville game. And you and I were remarking off camera, or off radio, I should say, it really felt like if Safford was a part of this lineup consistently, this whole season would have a different complexion for the RedHawks. And then moving down, you get Julian Lewis, who's really a spark plug guy for this team, then Billy Smith, who's really heated up as of late. I think he's solidified himself as one of the best three-point shooters on this team, and obviously you can't get away from Makai Larry and Anderson Mirambau in their own rights. They do both their jobs very well. The interesting thing with this lineup is how are they going to match up against a team objectively that you can say is more talented and you see on this hard test in Fifth Third Arena.
Absolutely. Miami now with every single member of their starting five averaging double digits per game, and also everybody over three rebounds. Certainly a tough starting five for the RedHawks that have solidified themselves as that group of five. On the Cincinnati side of things, it'll be Landers Nolly, Micah Adams-Woods, David DeJulius, Jeremiah Davenport, and Victor Lockin. Some guys that came off the bench in the game last year for the Bearcats, a couple of guys that gave Miami fits in the game a year ago. But bottom line is there's a lot of talent on this UC roster. They're yet to really, it seems, put that together and get some quality wins heading into conference play, but a team that has all the necessary pieces.
Yeah, they've struggled to this point, and it is worth noting, Luke, obviously Travis Steele is no stranger to Fifth Third Arena. In fact, he picked up two wins in his time here. Even at Xavier, in a career that wasn't that impressive in the long run for the Musketeers, he had his way against UC in the times he played them at Fifth Third. So at least Travis Steele does have that familiarity factor. But it just certainly feels like a different team that UC has this year. They struggled in the non-conference, but that's to be expected with a new team that's trying to figure things out. Obviously, they've plugged different guys in the lineup. They've had some guys that have really stepped up. But it just seems like they're starting to turn that corner. They had what was looking to be a blowout against a really talented Xavier team and one of the best rivalries in all of college basketball. And they brought that thing down to the wire after being down 17 at half. So Wes Miller definitely has his team, I think, where he wants it to be. They could be in a little bit better position, but I think Wes Miller has to be happy with where he's at. You got to pick up this win and then two more in the non-conference before you get to AAC play, who they're no stranger. They got really good teams in that conference. Houston, a former number one, and we saw Memphis give Alabama all they wanted in Tuscaloosa last night.
Yeah, UC predicted third in the AAC in their final year in the conference behind those two teams you just mentioned. Zach, Houston, the preseason favorite with Memphis right on their heels. It's a Cincinnati team that went 18-15 a year ago and 7-11 in the American Conference. But 12-6 here at Fifth Third. They're 5-1 here this season. Started 5-0 before the loss over the weekend in the Crosstown Shootout against Xavier. It's a team that has a great atmosphere in all their sports. We know that, Zach. We saw them play the RedHawk football team here earlier this year in what was a home game for the RedHawks played at Paul Brown Stadium. But the UC fans brought the ruckus, and that certainly looks to be the case again tonight in a Fifth Third arena that is increasingly growing in crowd size. Last season, a couple guys in the lineup for UC that played in the game like we mentioned earlier on. Last year, they were led by Jeremiah Davenport, the Moeller graduate, and their current graduate assistant, Abdul Abo. Each had 14 points in the game. Micah Adams-Woods, the Syracuse native, who was in the starting lineup for UC, really struggled in the game against the RedHawks last year, went 1-for-12 from the field. Was third on the team in points a season ago, averaging 8.6 per game, averaging 8.4 this season. Landers Nolly, David DeJulius, and Victor Lockin in double digits for Cincinnati. It's a Miami team that's really struggled to rebound the ball, Zach. So far this season, ninth in rebound margin in the MAC, and this is going to be a tough, tough matchup for them on the boards against a UC team that has a lot of size over them. Eight guys, 6'7" or taller, and just a team that's very, very talented, finishing near the top of the AAC in terms of rebound.
Yeah, and this is a team that can absolutely crash the boards. They gave Xavier all they could handle on the boards. I think Xavier got off to a quick start, but in that second half, you really started to see them dial in, and one of the key players for that game was obviously Victor Lockett, the big fella down low. He struggled with foul trouble in his career here at UC, but he's really started to turn the corner, had 16 points against Xavier. He's averaging just under 12 points per game this season, just under 8 rebounds per game, and he's shooting 68% from the field. So a lot to like from your starting five, your Wes Miller, and obviously the one that we've seen year in and year out lead this UC team, David DeJulius, had playing experience elsewhere before he came here. Just a big-time player. We saw him make that one and 1-3 at the end of that Xavier game that really put UC right back in it. Tied things up, in fact, with that four-point play. He had 22 in that game, just under 17 points per game, and he's shooting just under 50% from the field this year. So a lot to like out of David DeJulius. I think the offense is going to run through those two, but you're absolutely right. If you're Miami and you're trying to steal a win here at Fifth Third Arena, you have got to crash the glass, whether it's Morgan Safford, Anderson Mirambau, or other guys around the court. It's got to be a full-forced effort, and you're going to really have to play your best game against this UC team.
UC team very experienced. 9 total players in their final year of eligibility. Wes Miller looking to bring in a big recruiting class. He's got E.J. Walker, a 4-star from Kentucky, in attendance today. A big game for the Bearcats as they look to build that class and be a power in what Paul Frischner pregame called the best conference in college basketball, the Big 12, next season. RedHawks will move left to right here in half number one in the road red uniforms with white numbers on the front and back, in a white Miami in the traditional font across the front. For the UC, they are in the white uniforms with red accents. The Cats in script across the front with the red numbers on the front and back. Mirambau versus Lockin for the opening tip, and it was initially won by the RedHawks, but it went right to Micah Adams-Woods for UC. Underway here from Fifth Third, Bearcats on offense. Left-hand dribble to the near flank, David DeJulius with an overhead pass. Lockin working on Mirambau, right side of the paint, able to fling it back outside, where on the far wing, it's driven in by Davenport. He'll pull up from just outside the free throw line, in and out, rebound for the RedHawks by Makai Larry. 30 seconds gone by here in the first half. For the RedHawks, Julian Lewis waves a man inside. Mirambo's got it outside the arc now. Looking for an option, he'll hand to Safford, who just works his way in, finds Mirambau right side of the paint with a floater, and he got it.
Mirambau has really been good from that range in these games recently. He has found that stroke, and that's a shot you're really comfortable with if you're Travis Steele.
Here's Nolly, got it stripped away, then a nice backhand shovel pass to the far side. Adams-Woods takes a three in the face of the defender, and that one went into the corner, and it was saved off a jumping effort from Lockin. Now back into the corner, Adams-Woods stepped on the far sideline. Turnover to the RedHawks, 18:52 to go, 2-0 Miami.
That was an acrobatic play there by Victor Lockin, and he's one of those guys that he wouldn't really jump off the page at you if you just looked at him walk onto the basketball court, but his athleticism has really gone up under Wes Miller, and he's made some really nice plays for this team to keep them in games, and that was one of them there.
Lockin, member of the Russian youth national teams out of Anapa, Russia. RedHawks back on the offensive side. Pass intended for the back door is stripped away from Safford. Now back the other way. A pass is thrown directly into the foot of Billy Smith by David DeJulius, and that will draw a kickball. 18:35 to go, 2-0 RedHawks here in the first half. Travis Steele in his first game against UC in a Miami pullover. 3-1 at the helm of Xavier. Pass whipped to the far side out of the inbound. Hopping there near the top of the free throw line. That one just skied back out to half court by Nolly. Lockin hands it off. Here comes Nolly trying to drive down the near side of the paint. Runs a man over, and Larry is able to draw, I should say, the charge. It'll be on Landers Nolly. First team foul. And the RedHawks here, Zach, defending well early on. 18-17 to go, still yet to give up any points.
Yeah, and this is exactly what you want if you're Miami. This is the start you're going to have. You'd like to have seen maybe a three-pointer by this point in the game, but if you're hanging in there with UC early in this game, that's all you can really ask for, and you're just going to have to keep this game close at every stage of the game and then eventually pull away at the end. But great start for Miami. What was what you were desiring if you're Travis Steele?
RedHawks back on the offensive side. Lewis lost it for a moment, went back up, and he was blocked underneath the hoop by the guy freshly checked in at Aguama. Back the other way, a layup attempt is no good short, but a foul called as lock-in came down the right side of the paint. Falls into the courtside seats, looks like everyone is okay. Foul will be on Billy Smith. First personal in the team's first. It's a UC team that can deliver the block pretty well. Victor Lock-in, the guy at the free throw line, is the man who usually does it, but that time it was Odi Aguama. Lock-in, just a 42% free throw shooter on the year, but he knocks the first one down. It's a UC team coming off a performance against Xavier where they went 16 for 18 from the line. By percentage, the best they've ever done in the Wes Miller era. Bearcat team 10th in the AAC, shooting just 66% from the charity stripe on the season. 2-1 Miami, pending the second free throw from Victor Lock-in. 17:58 to go here in the first half. With the ball in the right hand, Lock-in takes a breath, gives a couple dribbles and puts it up. And he got it. Rattling in, and we're tied at two with 17:58 to go here in the first. Some pressure applied. Julian Lewis, lightly tapped on by Nolly, able to cross back and forth and get it across the timeline. Now left-handed dribble at the hip, he switches to his right. Pass is stripped away from Arambo into the hands of Wes Miller on the UC bench. He'll stay with Miami. 2-2 our score with 17:45 to go here in the first half. Inbound provided by Julian Lewis for the RedHawks. Finds Marambo up top. Now this is Larry top of the key. Gets past the first defender, just tripped up, and Larry goes down. Travel will be called on him as he just kind of rolled around on the ground. An awkward-looking play from Makai Larry, who's wincing and has a little bit of a limp as he heads back to his own side of the court. Just kind of a sloppy possession there, Zach, for the RedHawks, and they come up empty.
Yeah, and an interesting matchup we've got going on. Billy Smith on Victor Lock-in. It seems like one that you'd probably want to exploit if you're Travis Steele, because you have to imagine Billy Smith's going to have a step on the seven-footer.
Lock-in tried to deliver a screen, and just crazy stuff happened afterward. Everyone collapsing on the ground, and finally a foul is called as DeJulius tried to put a shot up. Looks like it's going to be a foul on the RedHawks before the shot. It'll be on Morgan Safford, and so it'll bring the inbound to the baseline here on the near side for UC. Safford picks up his first, second team foul for the RedHawks. Quickly into the corner, navigating the pressure, DeJulius finds a wide open Nolly, who dribbles his way in and puts up a floater from 15 feet that goes.
Yeah, Nolly's a dangerous scorer. He can elevate, and when he gets off his feet, he's just as dangerous as when he's playing off too. And that was a great shot that he drilled from the elbow there.
Nolly, senior from Atlanta, Georgia, makes it 4-2 UC, 3 minutes gone by first half. Smith fakes the three, now he finds Marambo outside the arc, big man triple wide right, and rebounded for Cincinnati by Adams Woods. Adams Woods finds Nolly, able to pull it away from the defender, puts up a three of his own and knocks it down. Landers Nolly, 41% three-point shooter. Knocked that one down at Billy Smith's face, and that quickly, it's 7-2 UC. Crossing back and forth is Makai Larry. Got a little bit of separation, but elects to take this one back outside to the fifth third logo, outside the arc on the far side. Now Marambo trying to play some bully ball, makes his way into the paint, floats one up too strong over top of the basket, tie up on the rebound, and a jump ball will be called. Possession arrow with the RedHawks.
Yeah, and if you're Travis Steele, you have to be somewhat frustrated there. You had two guys on Morgan Safford, and it seemed like Victor Lock-in was draped over Safford's back. No foul call. They called it the jump ball there. He retained possession, but it certainly felt like they could have whistled the Bearcats on that possession.
RedHawks make three subs as Lewis, Marambo, and Safford are out. Inbounding for Miami, Makai Larry underneath the basket. He'll just sky that one out for Ryan Mabry beyond the arc, who will take the three and hit it. Ryan Mabry, who's come alive as of late, has got his scoring tally up to nearly 9 points a game. shooting 30% now from beyond the arc, makes it 7-5. Back on offense, UC jabbing near the free throw line, no separation for Lockin, dumps it back out for Nolly. Nolly, cross court pass to the near side, three ball for Adams Woods is good.
Getting a little too zealous on the helpful on the help defense there, over rotating. We've seen that two times now, a wide open three for UC.
15:43 to go, 10-5 Bearcats. Reach-in foul was called there as Jaquel Morris tried to hand that one to Makai Larry. And that will take us to immediate timeout as the RedHawks will inbound with 15:40 to go. Bearcats 2-for-3 from beyond the arc. It's fueled them to an early 10-5 lead. We'll return to Fifth Third Arena in just a moment. Stay with us. This is Miami Basketball on RedHawk Radio. UC over Miami with 15:40 to go here in half number one. RedHawks will have possession coming out of this media timeout with 20 to shoot. And checking into the game, Zach Rengers, Kamari Williams in his second year with the Hawks was academically ineligible throughout the majority of the early part of the season. Going to make his first appearance of the year. The junior out of Sandy Spring, Maryland, who really came alive last season for the RedHawks. In preseason, Travis Steele expressed some frustration with the NCAA about not hearing about an appeal for Williams to play. But it looks like they finally got that situation cleared. And a guy that Travis Steele called one of their best offensive talents in Kamari Williams in preseason, who really came alive at the end of last year, 11.4 points per game over his last five, checking into the game here for the Hawks.
Yeah, and this is a huge development for the RedHawks because Kamari Williams brings some size to kind of bridge the gap between what UC has on the floor and what Miami does. Because how many times, Luke, in this early game have we seen just the size mismatch for Miami that favors the Cats? And this will be a really big stretch to see if Kamari Williams can't get going early in this one.
Quickly, a Mabry three, a little too strong, and the rebound for UC by Adams Woods. They're going to try to run the floor quick now, pulling up left side of the arc is Nolly. Around the horn to the far side, a three taken in the face of Mabry off the back iron. That was delivered by Adams Woods. Or rather, I should say, Skillings Jr. rebounded for the RedHawks by Makai Larry. Here's Kamari Williams, bounce pass to the near wing. Jaquel Morris back to Williams on the far side. Williams trying to cut back and forth. As a man in his face, that's Nolly. Now just putting up a three with under 10 to shoot is Makai Larry. He'll hit it. Both teams with a pair of three-point buckets early, trying to drive the baseline there with Skillings Jr. He was hampered and will have to turn that one back outside. Left to right, back to left-hand dribble. Eventually sent to the near side for Skillings Jr. Woods wants a screen, gets it at the top as Larry able to close him off quickly. Now back to the near side. Fake shot by Nolly. He'll drive the baseline, just put up a floater right outside the paint. And that's an easy bucket.
Yeah, Nolly's just a mismatch for most of these guys on the Miami defensive end. He's just so long, can stretch the floor, and he's great off the dribble like he was there.
7 points for UC's second leading scorer here early on. 12-8 Bearcats, 14-14 to go here in the first. A That ball stripped away from Jaquel Morris into the UC bench. It'll stay with Miami. Disruptive play there from Odia Guama. Wake Forest transfer.
And what a job Wes Miller has done assimilating talent for this Bearcats roster that after John Brandon left, everyone in the building would say was just in complete shambles when Wes Miller took it over. But since then, he's had a couple years to really try to get his guys on the floor, and he's done a great job of doing so.
An offensive foul called there on the RedHawks away from the ball as Julian Lewis tried to cut that one down the lane. Third team foul for the RedHawks as Anderson Marambo will check back in for Jaquel Morris, who just picked up the foul. But yeah, back to your point, Zach, it's a UC team that brought in three transfers this season who all have experience playing in the NCAA tournament. They're a team that wants that presence of playing in those big moments. 12-8 Bearcats, 6 minutes gone by. Handoff, Skillings Jr. races to the far side, puts up a shot. That one rattles away, and the rebound for the RedHawks by Marambo. Quickly up the floor, Mabry, two hands in on the far side, back to Marambo, top of the key, and now Kamari Williams. Williams double covered on the near wing. Finds Marambo, just waits for an option, lifts it up, and coming down with it is Morgan Safford. Now to the far side, a three-pointer is too strong from Lewis. Rebound fought for and gained offensively by the RedHawks, put back up. Marambo got the and one.
And what did we see right there? Kamari Williams stretches the floor, and he's able to crash the boards on that one. While he didn't retain the rebound, he was able to knock it around right into the hands of Marambo, and we've seen how strong he can be around the rack and able to finish there and go to the line for an and one opportunity.
He's got the student section with the Skyline Chili signs behind him, and Marambo will miss it. A 90.3% free throw shooter, but couldn't get that one to fall, and the lead stays at two. 12-10 UC, 13-20 to go here in the first half. Along the near side, Josh Reed gives an overhead pass to Julius. Awkward shot, hits off the front iron, then the backboard, rebounded by Kamari Williams for the RedHawks. Williams will pick up his first board, racing down the left lane and blocked as Lewis running the other way. Jared Hensley finding DeJulius, gets the foul and the bucket. David DeJulius gets his first points of the night. And UC, who's tried to use that transition game a couple of times, finally able to get a bucket off it. And with 12:59 to go, a chance for the old-fashioned three-point play from David DeJulius, a 77% free throw shooter, and a chance to make the lead five.
Yeah, and David DeJulius, just the king of awkward shots, whether it's behind the arc or finishing with contact. This guy is a seasoned veteran, and he is almost comfortable in the uncomfortable at this point in his career.
He'll knock the free throw down, 15-10. UC leads Miami, 12:51 to go here in the first half. Marambo, closely guarded by Locken, forces one over to Mabry, who's there. Mabry, in the lane, found Julian Lewis looking for a cross-court pass. That found a UC arm, and it's picked up. Here come the Bearcats. This is DeJulius, fakes, gets Safford to leap in the air, got it back. Safford stripped it away. It'll go out the baseline and stay with UC. DeJulius wanted a reach-in foul called there on Morgan Safford, who looked like he just kind of panicked when he lost the clamps on David DeJulius. And he was able to pry the ball free and not draw the contact. Makai Larry will come in for Julian Lewis. So the William and Mary transfer out and the RedHawks vet in. 15-10, our score, UC leads. Inbounded into the far corner, Reed three, too strong, rebounded by Kamari Williams. Up the far side of the court, it's passed up to Safford. Safford back to Williams up top, who will settle down. Williams between the legs spins, no space there created against Julius. We'll dump it off for Larry. Larry behind the back, dribbles down the left lane, kicks it out for Safford, right wing three, wide left, and rebounded by Victor Locken. Locken had that inside position. He'll send it to DeJulius, who will carry across the midcourt stripe. Between the legs, he spins down the lane, puts up an awkward look and hits it. David DeJulius. 17-10 UC, 11:50 to go here in the first. Safford in for Marambo with his foot on the line, just tries to send one to the back door, found Williams, who kicks to the far corner. Mabry thought about the shot, didn't give. Instead, Marambo just inside the arc on the far side, hands to Kamari Williams, takes a three and knocks it down. Kamari Williams, a 38% three-point shooter in his career at Miami, makes it 17-13. RedHawks hanging around here. And quickly to Julius the other way, puts up another awkward shot in traffic and able to get it to fall. David DeJulius now with 7 points to match the team high from Nolly. 19-13 UC. Marambo just to the left of the key. Hands to Safford, heads into the paint. Safford, high one-handed pass, pulled down by Mabry, puts up a three. It's a little short, rebounded offensively by Marambo on the far side. Dumps it off to Williams in the corner. Thought about the shot, steady pulls it back down. Finds Marambo wide open in the mid-range, and he'll take the shot and knock it down.
Great dump off there by Kamari Williams, and the same shot we saw from Anderson Marambo to start off the game, just on the other side of the floor.
Quickly the other way, David DeJulius with another two-pointer. Rather a three. He was just behind that point of the arc on the far side, and that'll open up a 7-point UC lead with 10:21 to go. The ball slipped through traffic underneath, and a jump ball is called as that one was ripped away from Anderson Marambo. Miami will turn the ball over here with 10:16 to go, trailing by 7. RedHawks started off well, they backed off a little bit, and this lead has a chance to maybe get into double digits for UC when we return. They'll have the ball. 10:16 to go, back to Fifth Third Arena in just a moment. Stay with us, Miami Basketball on RedHawk Radio. To 15, our score with UC leading Miami. 10:16 to go here in the first half. UC team that scores the basketball really, really well. One of the top teams in terms of points per game in the AAC coming into this one, and they've shown it. Shooting 57% from the field early on, 8 for 14, 3 for 7 from 3. But for the RedHawks, a big number in their column, not shooting the ball excessively bad at 46%, but 6 turnovers in the early goings here. So we are about to cross the 10-minute mark, and they find themselves down 7. Just gave up the ball to UC off a jump ball underneath the basket from Anderson Marambo. He was trying to go up with it. And UC will have possession coming out of this timeout.
Yeah, and Luke, the story of the game for Miami offensively, they're not shooting it extremely poorly, but how many times have we seen UC really get that shot clock down for the RedHawks and force a less than desirable outside three-point shot that just kind of seems like it's heaved up there at the last second? It just seems like a lot of time Miami is not able to penetrate against this stout defensive team from the Bearcats.
Both these teams have hit a couple circus shots early on. But most of them coming from the game's leading scorer, David DeJulius on the UC side, the only man in double digits right now with 10 points.
And we saw DeJulius hit that kind of circus shot at the end, and he was looking for a foul. It's worth noting that DeJulius is a phenomenal player in college, but the new flopping technical rule was designed for David DeJulius. Obviously not designed just after him, but his type of player, the guy that makes all these acrobatic shots and constantly has limbs flying everywhere trying to draw fouls, that's exactly who that rule was designed for.
Mid-range jumper doesn't go for Nolly. Offensive rebound put back up too strong by Reed. takes a couple of touches on its way out, but a foul is called on the rebound, so we won't get a call as to who touched it last. It'll be on Ryan Mabry on the rebound, his first. Mike Adams-Woods comes back in to replace David DeJulius for UC. And the Bearcats inbound from the baseline into the corner. Nolly thought about the shot and a pass that got popped away from Reed. Larry's going to be whistled for the foul right in front of the Miami bench, and nobody can believe it down there.
Yeah, and Luke, obviously you never want to blame the refs for anything, but it just seems like the fouls right now are a little ticky-tack. These are this UC team is known for its physicality, and I think Miami's going to try to match that physicality in the matchup, and they've called some fouls that are very borderline, it would seem.
Lock in, far side of the paint, works his way in, puts it up with the right hand and gets the roll. 24-15 UC. Victor Lock in with 4 points. Perfect from the field as well. Jaquel Morris has it now right side. He'll one-hand it over to Safford, makes his way towards the middle, forces a pass through the middle. Two Bearcats there, taken away by Lockin. Lockin finds Adams Woods up ahead, kicked all the way into the corner. Reed for three, got it. And a timeout immediately called by Travis Steele. RedHawks have blown up coming out of that media timeout. And a lead that was once 7, now 12 after a couple of quick possessions with a turnover sandwiched in between. RedHawks trail 27-15 now with 9:08 to go here in the first half. And it is a full media. We will take a break here on RedHawk Radio. UC with a 12-point lead. Back to fifth third in a moment. UC 27, Miami 15, 9:08 to go here in the first half at Fifth Third Arena. A lot of people hanging around here during this winter break. Fifth Third Arena pretty crowded. Good atmosphere. They've had a lot to cheer about as of late. UC with an 8-0 run after they have knocked down 5 of their last 7 field goals. That over just a minute 25 span, a run. RedHawks looking to get this one back into single digits. On the far side, Lewis works his way towards the middle, finds Larry on the near wing. Larry jabs twice towards the middle, goes behind the back, heads into the paint. Lost it, regained, forced one down low. It was stripped away from Kamari Williams, but he got the last touch as it headed out of bounds, and it's another turnover for the RedHawks.
Yeah, and Luke, it just seems like the RedHawks just do not have an answer for this smothering Cats D. They've got hands in every passing lane, it seems like, and they are just containing this whole offense that Miami's trying to run.
8th turnover of the game for the RedHawks. Adams Woods on the wing, gets a screen, now waves for another as he heads back out to the midcourt logo. With a man in his face, he'll find Davenport back at the logo as he headed to the far side. Nolly fakes the shot, he's got 3 to shoot, turns it around, look opens up on the near side, and he'll knock down the long 2. Landers Nolly now with 9 points off 4 for 5 shooting, I should say. Larry, left-hand dribble, works it into the corner. Lewis takes the 3, it's short, gets his own rebound, it's kicked right back to him. Awkward pass to the near side, and a 3 ball from Safford is good. Back and forth we go, 29-18, under 8 minutes to play here in the opening half.
J- just what the doctor ordered for Miami. Safford drains a nice three there, and right back in the thick of things if you're the RedHawks.
Landers Nolly pulls it back, takes a three, and hits it right in the face of Julian Lewis. Landers Nolly, first team all-conference selection from a season ago, as UC out in front by 14, 32 to 18. 7:26 to go in the opening half. RedHawks looking for an answer. Lewis on the near side, crossing back and forth. Passes it off to Kamari Williams. Contested three-pointer taken and drained by Morgan Safford. Kind of a settled type of shot there, but Safford able to hit it. And a pair of threes for Morgan. Quickly down the lane, putting that one in with a left hand. Micah Adams-Woods. That is his dominant side. Up the left side of the paint. Lead up to 13. 6:49 to go here in the first. Larry will pull this one back out to the logo. Larry behind the back, quickly to Safford. Heat check three is way long, and it's picked up by Josh Reed, who carries across the midcourt stripe. Now into the near corner, three taken over Safford's head by Davenport, and he hits that one as well. Travis Steele now gonna call his second timeout in a matter of minutes with 6:32 to go and a 16-point UC lead. The Bearcats are hot, 5-for-9 from beyond the arc, or 6-for-10, I should say, as things update, and they've got a 16-point lead with just over 6 minutes to play in the first. We'll be back to Fifth Third Arena in just a moment. Stay with us for more Miami basketball on Red Hawk Radio. To go, a 16-point lead has opened up for UC. 37-21 is our score, with the Bearcats on top. And Zach, this is starting to feel a little bit like that Marshall game. You run into a team that's shooting hot. UC 6 for their last 6 from the floor. Miami did not have an answer against the Thundering Herd a couple of weeks ago. Haven't had an answer so far tonight.
Yeah, no, and it just seems like right now UC has the entire edge in the game. They're locking down defensively on the RedHawks. They're stretching the floor well. They're getting in transition quickly. They're getting easy shots with high percentage. And then on offense, they are absolutely red hot from the field right now. And as a team, they're shooting 63.6% from the field and 60% from three. And that's really all you need to know if you're looking at this game by the stats thus far. It's just been a significant uphill battle for the RedHawks, and they have not had an answer, causing Travis Steele to use 2 timeouts early in this one.
Steele looking to stop the bleeding. RedHawks have turned the ball over 8 times in the opening 13-28. They've got the ball coming out of the timeout. A couple of looks that have been less than good for UC that they've hit anyway, and the RedHawks find themselves down now 37-21. Across the timeline, this is Larry. Works it to the far side, forced into the middle where Billy Smith is there at the free throw line, heads to the far side of the paint. Smith bounces it back outside for Larry. Larry with 9 to shoot, sends it in for Marambo, who will take the space in. Player falls down to the court, and a blocking foul is gonna be called as Marambo looked to put that shot up. UC fans can't believe it, but they're going to, I believe, get
Locking on a block.
For this, yeah.
And UC fans are unhappy because he went to the ground, but the issue with it was is he tried to establish position, but he was already falling backwards before he even got hit. So he didn't do a great job of selling it there. Obviously, this is a UC team that is stout defensively, and they pride themselves on taking charges. But that one was a little bit too Hollywood to be a true charge. So Locken's going to get whistled there, and Marambo's back at the line.
Second time Marambo at the line tonight, made the first. Now looking to go 2 for 2 after missing his opening free throw following an and-one opportunity earlier on. He'll knock the second one down. 37-23 now as the RedHawks finally able to break up this run a little bit and quiet down this crowd. Skillings Jr. to the top of the key. Overhead, Aguama to Adams Woods. Now to Julius, heads to the far side, puts up a three, no good. Rebounded by Aguama on offense. Aguama, near side of the paint, tries to spin on Marambo, who's got an arm up, but he finds Lockett underneath, who gives the slam. RedHawks just did not mark Victor Lockett. Yeah, that's just an easy slip pass in a wide open lane for a slam dunk for the big 6'11 Russian. 39-23 UC. Down the right side of the paint, high arcing shot is short from Marambo. Rebounded by UC, they'll come quickly up the floor. Baseball pass to the near side. Skillings Jr. drives the paint, goes up and under, and got it to go.
It's Skillings Jr., this is a freshman that they are very high on here at UC. I've talked to a lot of my friends that are Bearcat faithful, and they really like what this guy brings to the table, and they're excited to see what he can do with his career here.
Number 41 ranked prospect in the country is Skillings Jr. RedHawks now down by 18. Trying to go up for the shot there in the middle of the paint, and Safford was fouled as the ball just kind of kicked awkwardly almost into the tunnel. Victor Lockin will be given his second fifth team foul for UC. Morgan Safford will shoot the free throws. RedHawk team that came into this one top five in the nation in free throw shooting. Safford will hit the first. Ryan Mabry will come into the game, and he will replace Kamari Williams, or rather, now a miscommunication, he's going to replace Billy Smith.
And Luke, you mentioned top five shooting free throws in the country. You look at that comparison to Travis Steele's old days at Xavier, that is almost couldn't be farther from what happened at the Cintas Center. Xavier, under Chris Mack, his predecessor, was one of the best free throw shooting teams in the nation consistently. But once Travis Steele got there, the free throw shooting took a serious hit. And now back with Miami, and they've been great from the charity stripe.
Threaded underneath, Aguama will give another slam. And a couple of dunks now as we move down the stretch in this first half for UC. 43-25. Larry tried to go quickly down the right side lane as soon as he crossed half court, but he lost it, able to pick it off the court. Hand to Marambo. Marambo now back to Larry. Takes a mid-range look on the far side and swishes it. Took a little somersault in the back end of that one as well. And a 16-point lead for the Bearcats. 4:11 to go here in the first half. 43-27. UC on top. Two-handed to the far side. Skillings Jr. going to try to drive the baseline on Williams. And a foul will be called on Williams. And that is the seventh team foul for the RedHawks, so it's going to send Dan Skillings, a freshman out of Blackwood, New Jersey, to the line.
And Luke, the one thing I'm seeing on the offensive end from Miami, it just seems like obviously the help defense has been imposing from the Bearcats tonight, but it seems like Miami's almost timid to drive the ball at this point. We saw what looked like a pretty much wide open lane for Mekhi Larry, and he just stopped in his tracks. You would like to see, after so many errant three-point shots that have not really looked great, figure why not just drive it in and see what you get, but it seems like they're almost scared to right now.
Skillings Jr. knocks down the first, puts up the second, it's short. UC's got it on offense. Kalua Zikpe lost it. And a foul is called as Morgan Safford crashes down to the floor. Immediately, the hands go up towards the eyes for Safford. RedHawks tried to run the floor quickly after that one. Kalua Zikpe, the fifth-year senior, 6'8", was way above everybody on that rebound. It almost looked easy for him. He had three RedHawks surrounding him, but he lost it coming down. The Old Dominion transfer will turn it over, and Miami, trailing by 17, will have a chance to cut this lead down as the Mascots head onto the court here during Mascot Night at UC. With 4:02 remaining, RedHawks trail 44-27. Back to Clifton in a moment. This is Miami Basketball on RedHawk Radio. To go here in the first half, 44-27, UC leads Miami. Mascot night here at UC, good crowd, mascots from all the local sports teams here represented. They dove into the depths, they got the Skyline Chili mascot, they got the Florence Y'all's water tower, they got everybody. Gary the Lion from FC Cincinnati couldn't hit some clutch shots during the break. Mr. Red stole my water pregame when he came up to our spot.
Madness. They say mascot mania here, more like madness around Fifth Third Arena, and you're right, they got everyone covered from around the tri-state area.
Where is Swoop, though? No signs.
Yeah.
Out of the timeout, RedHawks carried across the timeline, left-hand dribble, Makai Larry will hand to Ryan Mabry, gets it right back on the right wing, heads to the baseline, but now pulls it right back out for Mabry, who skies one up. Marambo able to get two hands on it and put it off the back rim and in.
Looked like it might have been a miscommunication, but all that ends well is well for the RedHawks. They're able to just kind of lay that one in awkwardly. Anderson Marambo.
Marambo with 10 points now. Azekpe on the far side meets some trouble. Safford got two hands on the ball, but Azekpe able to pull it away and find Nolly. Skies it up with the right hand. No good. Rebound tipped right to Azekpe under the basket. Off the glass, too strong. Another offensive rebound by Reed, and now a foul called, or rather a jump ball. On the floor, RedHawks have the arrow, so Miami fortunate after giving up two offensive rebounds to not give up any points on the end of that possession. But Kalu Azekpe, who did not play at all in the early goings of this one, has checked in and made an impact for UC over the waning couple of minutes. For the RedHawks, Safford has it top of the key. He'll bounce it in for Mabry. Mabry drives into the paint, just puts up a shot that's well short, may have gotten tipped on the rebound. Azekpe nearly fell out of bounds, but he was able to push that one into the chest of Davenport. UC runs the floor to Julius, pulls back for a long two, in and out, rebound fought for and pulled away by Anderson Marambo. Marambo to Safford, now whipped to the far side as Larry will catch it across the timeline. Back to Marambo, top of the key, and now Larry once again on the far wing. Larry into the paint, puts one straight down the middle of a pair of defenders. No good, rebounded offensively by Marambo, and he'll finish up the loose change. And now Wes Miller wants to call a timeout of his own as the RedHawks have developed something of a run. UC 0 for their last four from the field, and the lead has diminished down to 13 points here with 2:34 to go.
Yeah, and a strategic timeout used there by Wes Miller. It's the use it or lose it, so obviously felt like you were going to use that at some point anyway. You're kind of letting the slide go here. Miami kind of getting hot on the offensive end, and then you saw Lockin go to the table there, so that means the big fella's going to check back in, and I think Wes Miller's going to try to get back to the starting group who played really well against this Miami RedHawk crew earlier in this game. Kind of wants to distance this lead again. We've seen it diminish down to 13 points here. They're going to look to replenish that lead and bring around a 17-point lead into halftime.
Azekpe and Reed, the two members of the starting that were not members of the starting five that are out on the floor prior to that timeout. Adams, Woods, and Lockin on the bench. They're going to stay off for now, but likely will check in soon. UC looking for their first points in a few possessions. Lead down to 13 with 2:30 to go here in the first half. 44-31 Bearcats. Back and forth they go. A few cross-court passes. DeJulius right back on the far side to Reed. Reed with a left-hand bounce back to DeJulius on the near wing. DeJulius crossing over on Mabry. Just enters the paint. Threads between a couple defenders. Puts up a right-handed shot, and it rattles home.
He's crafty. He just finds ways to get to the rim, and he's able to finish just about from any position on the floor.
Larry, two-handed to the far side. Marambo, with his back turned to the basket, will now turn towards it. Got some pressure and able to find the release valve in Safford. Safford on the double team now whips it across to Mabry, whose pass into the corner got deflected and taken away. Here comes Nolly behind the back pass and trying for a flying dunk. A hard foul there on Davenport, who is down under the basket. Able to get back up, though, as he will head to the line to shoot a couple free throws. He wanted to, look like, put up a dunk on the tail end of what would have been a wild play, and a pretty hard foul was given to him instead by Morgan Safford. Jeremiah Davenport already nursing an injury. He's got the Batman mask on the face. Cincinnati, Ohio native, who started every game this season for UC, will hit the first free throw. Julian Lewis comes in for Miami to replace Ryan Mabry. Micah Adams-Woods enters for UC. He will replace David DeJulius. 47-31, UC on top with 1:45 to go in half number one. UC led by Nolly and DeJulius with 12. Same mark on the Miami side for Anderson Marambo. 2-for-2 at the line now as the second shot is right through the nylon for Jeremiah Davenport. Larry nearly got trapped, able to get the corner on Nolly to get across the timeline. Now he heads to the far side, where he'll try to bounce one into the high post. Marambo able to get it. Shouldering into the paint, puts up a right-handed shot that is underneath the basket, way short. Landers Nolly, backhand dump pass. Adams Woods back underneath, and a right-handed layup opens up for Aguama, who hits it. Odi Aguama gives UC their largest lead of the night. 19 points now, 50-31. Larry to Marambo. Marambo hands it right back to him at the top of the key. Now Larry will take a shot from the free throw line and hit it. Larry. 17-point lead. Under a minute to play now here in half number one. Adams Woods sends a pass to Reed, who handed it right back to him. And a foul called on offense on UC away from the ball, as it was just being held by Aguama outside the arc. The foul will be on Josh Reed, seventh team foul for UC. Reed's first personal. And Miami will carry this one up the floor with 47 seconds to play in a 17-point hole. Larry, a metronome dribble with the right hand. Gives a quick spin, now cuts to the basket, kicks it back outside. Kamari Williams for three. That short doesn't hit rim. Putback attempt is no good as well for Safford, who's a little slow to get up, and now he will pop back up on his feet as Adams Woods will carry this one slowly across half court for UC. Shot and game clock separated by a second, so the Bearcats can't technically get this one to zero with the ball in their hands, but we'll be able to eliminate really any sort of offensive threat for Miami. 10 to go, an isolation play at the top for Adams Woods. Or rather, Landers Nolly will send it to the near side. Three-pointer put up by Davenport at short. Williams has it with 2 seconds left on the clock. Left-handed dribble up to half court. A heave, and it's wide right. And at the break, UC with a nice, sizable lead. Not the largest they've had all night, but pretty close to it. It's 17 points, 50-33, off a 55% three-point shooting performance and 58% shooting performance from the field. For the RedHawks, can't be necessarily too disappointed with how you shot the ball, but turned the ball over 10 times in the opening half and really struggled, felt a little overmatched on the defensive side of things then.
Yeah, and it just seemed like whenever Miami really got into a rhythm, right away we saw an even bigger punch come from UC in that half. It just seemed like they were shooting the lights out of the building, and on defense, they were just absolutely in Miami's grill. They could not get a pass off. They were constantly settling for outside shots that I don't think they love, and really just never saw them get into that rhythm that we've seen them in their winning efforts this year.
12 points for Anderson Marambo, only Miami player in double figures. Morgan Safford second on the team with 8 points for UC. DeJulius and Nolly each with 12. Followed pretty distantly behind by Victor Locken, who's got 6. 2 for 2 from the field and from the free throw line, though, is Locken. Capping off what's been a pretty solid shooting first half for this UC team. We'll take a break here at halftime from Fifth Third Arena, 50-33. UC on top of Miami. Back for the final 20 minutes in just a bit here on Red Hawk Radio.
and I, we're always on the edge. We fight and make love at the same time. Would you break up just because I told you what I did last night? I recall the times you said you're sorry, but still I'm not sure if you told lies. Give me a chance to make it right. Just let me touch you like the first time. We don't need answers to survive. Just let us keep on with the black guys. With the black guys. Hanging up to see if you would call me. You more when you seem too far away, and you can blame it all on me as long as we can find our way. Do you remember all the times we tried to stop this? Yeah, we end up the same every time, 'cause when our bodies meet, there's nothing left to fight about. We're holy when we touch anyhow. Give me a chance to make it right. Just let me touch you like the first time. We don't need answers to survive. Just let us keep on with the black guys. Give me a chance to make it right. Just let me touch you like the first time. We don't need answers to survive. Just let us keep on with the black guys. An imminent storm, it's unavoidable, yeah. But as long as I feel that you see me, I will pay no mind at all. So give me a chance to make it right. Just let me touch you like the first time. We don't need answers to survive. Just let us keep on with the black guys. Just let us keep on with the black guys. With the black guys.
Coming out of halftime here from Fifth Third Arena, 50-33 is the UC lead. Luke West Poley, Zach Ringers alongside. And Zach, we talked about the rebounding going into this one, an area where we thought the RedHawks would be overmatched. They haven't been so far, 15-15, but in a lot of other areas you could point to, there's been a clear disparity favoring the Bearcats in this one.
Yeah, and it's just talent right now, Luke. It just seems like these Bearcats are making more talented plays than what Miami is able to hold them to. Now, the one shining star that we've seen in the lineup, welcomed with open arms, I should say, is Kamari Williams. Played 16 minutes of that first half, and he really brings just a different gear to both this offense and defensive end. One of the longest players on the floor, got crazy long wingspan, and he's able to really make a lot of different matchup disparities for the other team because he can shoot it well, but he's a stretch forward, and he's really been awesome for this RedHawks lineup.
Kamari Williams appearing in his first game this season after playing in 30 a year ago. Averaged just 6 points per game last season, but if you look at his last five games, 11.4 in the point column was the average after playing 40 games at Boston College. Transferred over to play in Oxford last season after a couple seasons in Chestnut Hill in the ACC. And certainly a welcome addition, like you mentioned, Zach, to this Miami lineup. RedHawk team shooting 44% from the field right now, 80% from free throw on 4-for-5 attempts, 38% from three. But 9 turnovers for the RedHawks at the halftime break. UC continuing to shoot the lights out like they have all season long, 50% from beyond the arc, 58% from the field, 19-for-33 are the Bearcats. Only 6 points off the bench for Miami. And get this, 20-6. UC outscoring the RedHawks in the paint. Certainly been an area where that size advantage has come into play. The Bearcats have dipped deep into their bench set.
Yeah, and Luke, one guy we harped on, interestingly enough, not a player, Wes Miller, made some great substitutions in this one. One thing I did want to mention, they extended him today. So big day for this basketball program here at UC, who obviously, like we mentioned, was kind of in the dumps until Wes Miller took over this program, and he's done great things. And you're absolutely right. This team that he has assembled, like you said, brought in many transfers that have had NCAA appearances in their past. It just seems like that's where this team is trending, and they've done a great job of getting back there.
Wes Miller, former national champion player in North Carolina, came in to coach the Bearcats. Like you said, he was under contract till 2026 until this morning when they added 2 years onto the end of it. He'll be here in Cincinnati through at least 2028. Got a recruit in town as well, and E.J. Walker from just over the border and Lloyd High School in Kentucky. Certainly a big night for the Bearcats. Underway here in the second half with UC having possession. Now moving left to right across your radio. Down the left side of the paint, Adams Woods just put up a shot in double coverage and got fouled.
Foul line.
Foul be on Makai Larry. His second, and the first foul of the half for the RedHawks, just 13 seconds in.
Yeah, and that's not where you want to go if you're Miami. You cannot afford foul trouble against this team. You need to keep virtually your best five in there the whole game, and fouls are going to inhibit you from doing that, and they need to stay away from fouls in the second half.
Adams Woods hits the first free throw, 94.1% shooter from the line. That's the best on the team for an otherwise struggling Bearcat squad. And make it 2-for-2. UC's been good, though, as of late. We talked about what they did in the Xavier game, and they are now 8-for-9 tonight. 52-33, this ties the largest lead for the Bearcats of the night. Just over 20 seconds gone by here in the second half. Inside the arc, Safford will give to Larry, who one-hands it top of the key for Marambo. Rambo now sends an area pass, running into it. Safford in front of the Miami bench. Safford kicks back outside. Larry thought about a very deep three, instead pulls it back down, heads into the paint mid-range. That's near the paint, I should say. No good. Rebound taken away from Lockin. Safford couldn't clean up the easy bucket, and the second attempt is swiped away. Carrying up the court, it'll be DeJulius for the Bearcats. DeJulius has it back now after sending that one off, heads into the paint. Backdoor pass, missed its target, but found its way into the corner. Three ball is no good from Davenport. And rebounded for the RedHawks by Lewis. Quickly up to Safford up the far sideline. He will be fouled when he was going up and under. Adams Woods got a little handsy. And they're going to say that this was not a shooting foul, as Safford was attempting to make a pass at that little up and under move. So the RedHawks will inbound on the baseline. Larry finds Smith right underneath the basket, completely unmarked with the left hand. He puts it off the glass and in. Billy Smith, a local guy from Covcath, very close to here in Cincinnati, makes it 52-35. Smith, who had a very quiet first half, no points. Whipped near the paint by Nolly, spinning around. That pass, or shot I should say, from Lockin falls short, and the RedHawks able to get the rebound. Here's Larry on the far wing. Two hands at the top of the key for Marambo. Left hand dribble to the near side, he hands to Safford. Safford squeezes that pass through back to Marambo at the free throw line, working on Lockin. He spins, and a pass outside is tipped away, intended for Safford. Nolly got to it. Nolly runs the floor, sends a pass across the basket. That got by Lockin, who was intended for it there, and it'll go out of bounds. A couple of turnovers on each side off some errant passes, and the RedHawks will get the ball back. Anderson Marambo comes out of the game for the RedHawks to be replaced by Jaquel Morris. Morris, who had limited minutes, only three in that first half.
Yeah, Luke, if you're worried about rebounds, Jaquel Morris is your guy. Obviously, we've harped on it, what he averaged in high school, but he's brought that rebounding to the next level, and he's been really good on the boards.
Baseline drive and a right-handed layup for Billy Smith finds the nylon. And after that quiet first half, like we mentioned, Billy Smith on the board a couple of times here early in the second. 52-37 with 17:53 to go. UC leading, and an offensive foul quickly called on the other side. So it looked like Odia Guama was involved there with Jaquel Morris atop the key next to where the ball was.
Les Miller is hot right now. Screaming at his guys. He's had two sequences on defense and offense that he's not loved. That errant pass and then obviously a charge. Two things that are certainly going to frustrate him in the film room tomorrow.
Driving down the right side, Lewis lost it, taken away. DeJulius has space to go up ahead, and he will lay in the right side layup. Had Safford trailing behind him, elected to not go for the dunk, and a smart play. DeJulius able to find the scoreboard for UC for the second time here in this half. 54-37, Bearcat lead, 17:23 to go. On the far wing, Safford with a right-handed dribble, gives a high pass to Morris at the free throw line, slips it into Larry, who has a wide open red carpet to the basket. He'll lay that one off the glass and in. 9 points now for Makai Larry, off 4 for 6 from the field. Across the timeline, right-handed slow dribble from Adams Woods. Now he'll speed up and head down the left side, turns it to the right, circling the paint, back to the near side. He'll lay that one up top and put it in. Adams Woods able to put that one right through. But the Bearcats will call timeout following that bucket with 16:56 to go here in the second half. Lead has ballooned back out to 17 for Cincinnati.
Listen live to the Wes Miller Radio Show on Wednesday.
But like you said from a moment ago, Wes Miller not necessarily super happy with how his team has opened this second half. Keep you here for this media timeout. We'd like to remind you that as some streams coming up on Saturday, we will be in Louisville as the RedHawks will take on the Knights from Bellarmine. Really unique Bellarmine team that Paul Frischner talked about pregame. Should be a fun matchup between the RedHawks and the Knights. That's a 4 o'clock start on Saturday afternoon. The RedHawks will head to Louisville.
And Luke, a Bellarmine team that in the future you could forecast some scheduling issues for them. There have been coaches like Coach Musselman in Arkansas that has said publicly they will not schedule Bellarmine because of how good they are. A team that is generally known for playing in some of the best venues in college basketball as a bye game. They might have some issues going forward because they've gotten so good at playing their style of basketball. They pass a lot, they take a lot of time on the offensive end, and they really wear you down. So that's a team that to look out for in the future. Obviously, they're going to become a power in college basketball that makes it to the tournament most years, but they could certainly forecast some scheduling issues going forward because of how good they've gotten.
Bellarmine team that won the A-Sun last year. They're not eligible for the NCAA tournament because of transitioning rules, and really quite a shame because they are a good basketball team. Beat Louisville earlier this year. They play that unique style like you talked about. They don't dribble the basketball.
And even Coach Calipari from UK has come out publicly and said that he believes that there's something that needs to be done, because I think he's in the majority of college basketball fans that would say there's no reason that Bellarmine shouldn't have played in the tournament last year and shouldn't make it again this year, because it seems like they're on track to do exactly what they did a year prior.
Yeah, absolutely. A team that's supposed to make noise in the A-Sun this year. You understand why the transitional period exists. It allows teams that are moving up when they get those scholarships to kind of develop the recruiting for a little bit, but it's just so long that at times, with Bellarmine being the prime example right now, it can prevent teams from making the NCAA tournament. And really a shame, because that's a team that we've seen create upsets in the regular season in a March Madness tournament that's known for such. You can only imagine what the Knights would do to some of the best teams in the country if they were given a spot and an auto bid in the field of 68. 56-39 in our game with 16:56 to go. As the RedHawks trail the Bearcats. Miami with possession. Morgan Safford inbounds on the baseline to Makai Larry, who will race up the near side of the court now. Puts it behind the back and heads across the half-court logo. He hands to Safford. Now two-handed pass to Mabry. Bounces it up to the elbow. Morris skies it to Safford. Back out. Wide open three for Mabry. Off the back iron and rebounded for UC by Landers Nolly. Nolly up to the top of the key slowly. Finds DeJulius on the far wing. DeJulius fakes to go inside. Now spins toward the paint. DeJulius puts up an off-balance look and finds it. Some words on the way back for DeJulius. RedHawks go quick. Smith back outside on the far side for Safford, who will wave him back into the paint. Bounces it into the near elbow for Jaquel Morris. Back to Safford. Wide open lane to the right side. He'll lay that one off the glass and in. Team's trading buckets here in the opening minutes. 16:02 to go in the half. And a 17-point lead for UC, 58-41. DeJulius, between the legs, dribble, waves a man into the paint with the left hand. Two-hand pass to Adams Woods. He runs across him and gets it right back. Now he will send to Adams Woods on the far wing. Adams Woods back to DeJulius with seven to shoot. DeJulius around to the corner, slipped and fell with Ryan Mabry on him, but a foul will be called. Mabry got in his way.
Not a foul you love if you're Mabry there, just dribbling around, not even making an effort to drive to the cup. And you give him that foul to bail him out. Now they get a fresh 20 on the timer, and you kind of reset the offense coming out of this media timeout.
That's Mabry's second. Like Zach said, we have reached a media timeout with 15:41 to go. Looking ahead for Miami, they've got Wright State just before the Christmas break on December the 22nd, a week and a day from now. That game is at the Lett Hall. What's become a nice rivalry between the RedHawks and the Raiders. Wright State team that made the tournament last year lost some of those weapons. But that closes out a tough three-game stretch for the RedHawks heading into the Christmas break, and they will come out of it what I'm sure Travis Steele and the coaching staff hope can be a bit of an ease-in game into the conference schedule, as they will take on St. Mary of the Woods as a bit of a tune-up before starting the new year in Mount Pleasant against Central Michigan. Do you want to give a shout-out to someone who's been very kind to us at Red Hawk Radio throughout our time, Mr. Jude Killey, former deputy athletic director at Miami University, one of the best people you'll ever meet in college athletics. He's been so great to us, Patrick, Yeshin, I, and Zach Rengers, and all of us here at Red Hawk Radio. He's providing us with everything that we've needed over the course of our time here, and a well-deserved trip to New England for Jude Killey, who accepted the job to be the new athletic director at the University of Maine. Congratulations to Jude. We will miss you very much here at Miami, but a huge, huge congrats on being named the head honcho for the Black Bears in Maine. And can only hope that the Black Bears will be put on the schedule in maybe hockey or football in the coming years. We'd love to see you back in Oxford. Congratulations on the job, Jude. Red Hawk football team right now in the Bahamas. Good luck to them. They will take on UAB. Heavily favored UAB team, I might add, on Friday at 11:30. A lot of news in between our last football broadcast and now. Brett Gabbert entered the transfer portal. Brett Gabbert withdrew from the transfer portal. He is coming back for another season with the Red Hawks. Miami lost John Saunders Jr. to the portal. He looks like he will not be returning. Got offered by Ole Miss a couple days ago. Crystal ball predictions look like he's going to be a Rebel next year. But very excited to see Brett Gabbert returning for the RedHawks. Had his season hampered by injury. Won't play in the Bahamas Bowl, so we can keep that injury red shirt. NCAA rules allow you the 4 games, which is the exact number he's at right now. So he's going to sit out the bowl to keep that year of eligibility. And he'll have 2 remaining and hopefully 2 storybook ones for the RedHawks moving forward. Timeout over, 58-41 UC with 15:41 to go. Bearcats inbounding on the near side in front of their own bench. Nolly with some trouble getting it in. Adams Woods double covered. Now pops it right underneath the basket. A two-hand slam. Odi Aguama wide open. RedHawks tried to just swarm the ball there, but UC cunning on the navigation. Safford just holding it near the logo for the RedHawks. Just slips one across to the far side for Morris, who hands to Smith. Puts up a slightly contested three. That's off the mark. Rebound is stripped away from Skillings Jr., who got it, but it fell right into the hands of Adams Woods for UC. High ball into the far corner. Nolly for three. No. Rebound. Mabry initially had it. Fell out of his hands. Picked up by UC. Under the basket, this is Lockin. Puts a shoulder into his man and puts that one off the back iron and in. Travis Steele very, very frustrated with the official as the RedHawks move this one back up the court. Between the legs, Makai Larry heads across the Black Sea. Just kind of slapping his man who's on, and that's Adams Woods. Larry for Smith, now back to Larry, trying to draw up a play. Sent one into traffic. Jaquel Morris able to pick that one away from a pair of defenders. 6 to shoot. Billy Smith got it at the logo. Tried to send it to Safford. It's tipped into the scorers table. 4 to shoot now for the RedHawks. They will inbound from just to the right of their own bench. Anderson Marambo will come in for Jaquel Morris. Victor Lockin comes out for UC. Morgan Safford will be the inbounder for the RedHawks. Slaps the basketball. Baseball pass to the far side. Marambo is open, decides not to take a look. Feeds for Larry, three-pointer off the mark. UC fighting themselves for it. 2 players there, and stepping on the baseline there was Nolly. Just a miscommunication. Nolly and Skillings Jr. were both there. There were no RedHawks in sight. And they were almost fighting each other for the rebound. I don't know if they thought the other one was a member of the RedHawks or what. But through all that, Nolly stepped on the baseline. RedHawks get it right back. Larry puts it up high where only Marambo can get it. He'll head into the paint. Puts a line driver off the backboard and gets called, or draws the foul, I should say. And so it will be 2 shots at the line for Anderson Marambo, something that's been familiar territory for him tonight. This is now his 3rd trip, the most of any RedHawk.
And he's up to 12 points on the night. Obviously, you know with Anderson's playing style, you got to get him a break here or there, but you maybe like to see him on the floor a little more.
Hit the first one as Victor Lockin comes back in for UC. Kamari Williams will enter for Miami. Yeah, a guy who's been a mainstay in the starting lineup, but 23 minutes per game for the RedHawks is the lowest of any of those regular starters. Big 6'8", 305 Anderson Marambo and a Santo Domingo Dominican Republic. 2 for 2 from the line. Second one, nothing but net. Lead is back under 20, 62-43 with 14:14 to go. RedHawks applying light pressure. Back and forth cross-court passes between Julius and Nolly. And now quickly as they get it across the timeline under the basket. One put high off the glass by Lockin. That goes. Larry up the near side. Now backing toward the Miami bench. Just delivered a pass to Marambo that got stripped away. Here comes Lockin on a wide open lane. He'll put it in with one hand on the slam. RedHawks continue to struggle passing the ball through those tight lanes. UC has given them fits. Larry top of the key. Finds a little bit of space to the near elbow. Now kicks for Safford. 3-pointer. No good. Rebound. Marambo slaps it to himself. Tried to slip it to Mabry, but there was a man in the way. Skillings Jr. took it away. He finds the Julius. Now he'll sky that one to Nolly in the far corner. Nolly baseball pass to the near side. Now up to the wing for the Julius for three, and he hits it. Travis Steele is livid on the Miami sideline. He'll burn a timeout. 26-point lead for the Bearcats, 69-43, with 13:18 to go here in the second half. This has quickly become a blowout as UC continuing to do what they do best, shoot the lights out. 26-point lead for the Bearcats, back to fifth third in a bit. This is Miami Basketball on Red Hawk Radio. To 43 is the Bearcat lead. That is a three-pointer by David DeJulius, graduate student out of Detroit. Electrified fifth third arena. He's got 19 points and continuing to shoot at a high clip, 8-for-11 from the field. At the timeout, nearly a turnover there as Safford was looking for Marambo, but he was able to recover it. Marambo now hands on the far side to Larry, works into the paint, and he is able to draw the foul. Victor Locken was lurking over the top of him looking for an emphatic block, but he's not going to have a chance for it. The foul is going to be on Josh Reed. Fourth team foul for the Bearcats, second personal. Makai Larry to shoot. 95% free throw shooter coming into this one. First trip to the line tonight. He's got 9 points. Speakers went off as he fired the first one off, but it finds nothing but net. Kyle Larry's free throw shooting is just an art to watch. Watch the game against Georgia when he went off for 34 points, and I think the guys down there put it best to recall in the game. They didn't get to see Larry much, but they were amazed by the fact that his free throws never seemed to even hit the rim. Seems like the bucket is huge when Makai Larry's at the line. And the second one won't hit the rim either, right through.
Yeah, just a lost art, it feels like, in college basketball. I remember back in the days of Xavier, just multiple guys be up 90%, and I felt like that was kind of the mantra across college basketball, but that has not been the case in past years. It's almost a good thing if you're above 80% at any clip from the fraternity stripe in college basketball now.
Spinning down the paint, Lockett had a shot that was tipped and right into the bucket. Marambo looked like he got a hand on it, but it went off the backboard and rolled its way in. 71-45 is our score. Victor Locken has taken over this game rather quickly. 14 points for the big Russian. Kamari Williams on the near wing, working on Davenport. Can't get any space on him. He'll bounce it into the post where Marambo hands off to Safford. A little bit of space in the mid-range. Puts up an off-balance look and got it to go.
This team never ceases to amaze me with some of the awkward looks that they are able to convert on. Just, you need to hit your regular looks a little more often if you're Miami, and then you'll be golden in MAC play.
62% from the field of the Bearcats, 45 for the RedHawks. Working down the left lane, a foul is whistled on Anderson Marambo as Locken tried to spin down on him. First foul on Anderson. And it will send us to a timeout on the floor. 71-47 is the UC lead now. With 11:55 to go, it'll be Bearcat ball when we come back. This is Miami Basketball on Red Hawk Radio. 24-point lead for the Bearcats, 71-47 back here at Fifth Third Arena. Luke Westpoli, Zach Ringers alongside. This has become something of a theme throughout this game, Zach. You see five for their last five from the field. It has come in bunches for the Bearcats today.
Yeah, they're very streaky to this point in the season. I think Wes Miller, as they turn towards conference play in these next two games, will look to level them out, make sure that they're scoring at all points in the game. You're all for the streaks where you're hitting shots. It's just a matter of eliminating the streaks where you're not doing that. And I think they're trending in the right direction, but it's just a matter of doing these last final tune-ups before you get into the American.
Bearcat ball coming out of the timeout from the baseline. A ball put into the middle of the paint and a foul be called as Aguama fell down and just kind of slipped into the basket. Fourth team foul for the RedHawks. And just 1 second elapses. And stepping on the line there on the inbound was DeJulius. So he will turn the ball over to the RedHawks. Miami catches a break there. This one's rolled up the court where it's picked off the logo by Makai Larry. He'll give it back to Safford. Safford quarterbacking the offense from the top. Larry, or rather Mabry, back in for Safford, who was driving down the right side of the lane, just lost it. And out the baseline, it's UC ball.
They've run that play a couple times, little high ball screen up top, and Morgan Safford streaks to the basket, but UC's picked up on it, sent two guys in defense there, and they were able to knock it away.
Nearly a dunk, but a putback anyway from Jeremiah Davenport, who got some space on the right side of the paint. 73-47 now, Davenport with 7 points. Larry pulls up from the free throw line, off the back iron, rebound slapped out, chasing after it. Mabry couldn't get it off the fingertips into the Miami bench.
Davenport, one of the guys that has not played his usual full role tonight. Obviously, only 15 minutes in this game. Usually a guy that's closer to 20 to 24 by this point in the game.
UC brings on Adams Woods. They've got it with 11:05 remaining. Adams Woods has it, shadowing towards the near side, top of the key. Skillings Jr. off the screen, drills the three. Kamari Williams, who got hit with that screen pretty hard, was down. He will now slowly get up and walk across the timeline as Makai Larry brings it up the near wing. Between the legs, Larry will find Kamari Williams on the far side. And Travis Steele, it looks like, has called timeout.
Now they're giving him a technical.
Oh, rather, it is a technical on the Miami head coach. Seen a few of those from Travis this season.
Yeah, I mean, he's been working the refs pretty hard these last couple possessions. I think he had a case with Kamari Williams on that hard screen there, but a couple other times maybe a little bit in excess, and obviously that working the refs is a cumulative thing, and they're going to remember all of it. I think they had kind of just gotten towards the end they were going to take from Travis Steele before assessing that tech.
So Davenport, the 77% free throw shooter, knocks down the first. Here comes the second, and that one rattles its way in. Now a 31-point lead for UC, 78-47. Morgan Safford, along with Josh Reed, were running into the corner. Might have misunderstood, thought it was UC ball. RedHawks are going to get it back. They'll inbound across from their bench on the far side. Bounced into Makai Larry by Safford. Safford, or rather Larry, heads around the screen, and he is blocked in his mid-range attempt by Adams Woods out the baseline. Safford thought he had some space. Adams Woods was just out of his peripheral vision when he fired off that shot. Larry now inbounding from the baseline. Pass intended for Marambo is tipped away. Recovered by Mabry in the corner. Mabry one-hands it into Safford on the edge of the paint. Puts up a shot off the square and in. Morgan Safford, who's had a solid night. 12 points, saw 4 for 9 from the field. Adams Woods with his back turned to the basket, guarded loosely by Larry. Now has the ball in his hands as he's made his way to the near side. Adams Woods back around, working up the left side of the paint, threads between a pair of defenders, and a foul called as the ball was tipped away from him. It'll be on Anderson Marambo. That's his second. Sixth team foul for the RedHawks. Miami hasn't had to deal with too many foul issues. Only player with three fouls is Makai Larry. But still 10:09 to go. RedHawks are going to bring on Julian Lewis prior to this baseline inbound. He will come on from Makai Larry, something we've seen a little bit tonight. Quickly into the corner. Skillings Jr. couldn't get the shot. Now at the top of the key, Davenport fakes and gives back to Josh Reed. Reed's pass up top was tipped away by Kamari Williams. Tried to run up the floor, and a foul will be called on Skillings. Or rather, Micah Adams-Woods of UC as he pushed down on Kamari Williams. Billy Smith comes back in for the RedHawks. Smith, who's had really limited time out on the court. Miami going to inbound. Morgan Safford out for Julian Lewis. Lewis to Smith. And a foul called away from the ball as Smith was just holding on to it near half court.
And this is becoming somewhat of a theme in the second half for UC, just unnecessary fouls, just away from the ball. I'm all for hard fouls to make them earn it at the line and getting physical on the boards and whatnot, but it just seemed like backdoor cuts that are away from the ball that are the ones that UC are getting whistled for the most.
Safford with the right hand, skying shot falls short. Reed on the rebound for UC, spins as he crosses the timeline. Finds Adams Woods, who will race down to the baseline. Now a baseball pass up for Nolly. Thought about the three, instead he'll Euro step in. Right-handed shot rolls around and goes. Another circus look for UC finds its way in. Bearcats 7 for their last 7 from the field in an 80-49 game. They lead, 9:25 to go. Miami back on offense. Marambo finds Smith down low on the cut. He'll put that one off the rim and in. Billy Smith's done a good job finding those easy buckets. Three of them in the second half. Nolly heads to the far side, thought about the mid-range look, instead tried to backhand it in for Aguama. That was tipped away by Lewis. Lewis, overhead pass ahead for Kamari Williams in front of the Miami bench. Williams, heavily guarded by Davenport, sends an area pass out where it's hauled in by Lewis. Lewis to Marambo on the far side. He'll just bounce it back to Lewis near the logo. 10 to shoot as Lewis gives to Smith. Smith now drives baseline, goes up and under, and got the shot to go.
Some really nice finishes we've seen around the rim from the RedHawks in the second half. It just, they have not been able to get enough quality shots other than those hard looks that they finish, and that's why they're in such a deep hole against the Bearcats.
27-point lead for UC, 80-53 with 8:21 remaining. 10 to shoot for the Bearcats, who've just been tossing it around the arc. Now heading in is Adams Woods. A little bit of separation, puts one over top of the basket. Rebounded on offense by Reed. Kicks back out for Nolly. Thought about the three, now he takes it, and he hits it. Landers Nolly, their leader, now has 17 points and three trades. Marambo will secure the loose ball on the far side for the RedHawks. Puts a shoulder into Aguama, hands it off for Williams, who will take a contested three, and off the back iron, that one rattles in. Lead back under 30 at 83-56 with 7:38 to go. Working his way across the court, past the midcourt stripe, Micah Adams-Woods heads to the official and calls a timeout. That's 7:36 remaining, 24 to shoot for UC. They will have possession when we come back. 83-56, Bearcats on top in this one. And this is Miami Basketball on Red Hawk Radio. 7:36 remaining here at Fifth Third Arena. Some crowd hitting the exits. The remainder that is here are still going strong for UC. It's been a loud night. UC, second best shooting team in the AAC at 46.4% from the field, second best three-point team at 35%, and second best scoring team at 79 points per game. They've got 7:36 to go. They've already surpassed the scoring mark in terms of season average. They're shooting the ball at 64% right now from the field, and they're 53% from beyond the arc. UC could almost miss every shot for the rest of this game and still raise those season averages. They've had a night offensively, led by Landers Nolly with 17 and David DeJulius, who's on the bench right now with 19 points. Both those guys shooting over 70% from the field individually. But UC has had their way with Miami this evening.
Yeah, Luke, they're just shooting the lights out of the building right now, and doesn't look like it's stopping anytime soon. They're getting great high-quality looks, and they have been money from behind the arc as well. Just a full-forced effort from UC tonight, and I think that's exactly what Coach Wes Miller and company were looking for after a first half that was less than impressive against Xavier over the weekend. They've kind of put together a full minute, about 30 minutes and change, looking to make it a full 40 in this one, and they have certainly done that to this point.
UC team in one of their final tune-ups. They've got two more non-conference games before beginning AAC play. That will start against Tulane on December 29th, following the Christmas break first game for the Bearcats following an eight-day hiatus. Inbounding on the near sideline in front of the bench. This one's going to be sent all the way to the backcourt by Nolly, where it's picked up by Adams Woods. Back across the timeline, he'll send it to DeJulius. DeJulius gets around the screen, guarded by Morris. DeJulius works his way across to the left side of the paint. Shot is swatted away, but quickly picked up by UC. Ezekpe back outside for Nolly. Three-pointer contested, doesn't matter.
Nolly has just been a killer, up to 17 points on the night, and 20 points on the night now, and he's been awesome.
Four for five from beyond the arc as well.
Yeah.
Billy Smith for Miami at the free throw line. Backhands it over, a three-pointer from Lewis off the front of the rim. Scramble for the rebound outside the arc where it's picked up by DeJulius. Sends one ahead for Hensley, and he got it off the left side of the glass and in. Jared Hensley, who played a year under Wes Miller at UNC Greensboro, then followed him to UC. Ryan Mabry struggling to get this one across the timeline, and Nolly was trying to trap him into the corner with just 2 seconds remaining before a 10-second violation is going to be called for the foul, and the UC fans not having any of it. 6:39 to go in an 88-56 game led by UC. Ryan Mabry now shooting the bonus for the RedHawks. Mabry not a guy that shoots a ton of free throws, just 3 for 4 on the season. He'll hit the first. Still a bit of a buzz around a Fifth Third Arena that has gone from about 75% full to about 60% full over the past few minutes. Second free throw right through for Ryan Mabry. 30-point lead for the Bearcats with 6:36 to go, 88-58. Slow dribble across the timeline from Adams Woods with the left hand. Now he'll move to his right and direct traffic with the left. Adams Woods, loosely guarded by Billy Smith. Puts the ball over his head, doesn't make the pass, 10 to shoot, heads to the far side, now he's double covered. Hensley into the corner. DeJulius thought about the three, instead he'll race out to the top of the arc, step back with one to shoot, and he knocked it down.
Not much defense you can play on that step back three, even over some of the tallest players in college basketball. You're not really going to find a remedy for that one.
Billy Smith having a lot of trouble. And the RedHawks going to be whistled for the 10-second violation after a nice press on the combo from Dan Skillings Jr. and Landers Nolly. So UC is going to get the ball back here. The 91-58 lead. Makai Larry in for Kamari Williams. But back to that shot from David DeJulius, that's just been one that UC's had tonight, and Miami has not, and UC's really had it all season. Just a fantastic shooting team Wes Miller has at his disposal. DeJulius sends a high ball to the far side where Hensley's there. He'll drive into the paint and just dump it off for Ezekpe, who puts it between a couple of defenders. off the right side of the rim and in.
Luke, this team can pass like no other. Just great court vision from seemingly every, all five on the floor, and they've got even better chemistry on the offensive end.
Smith with a far side three off the front of the rim. Tipped away but secured for Miami by Morris, and he lays down a one-handed slam.
Morris is going to be special for this group. Once they get him to develop, especially on the offensive end a little more, it can be very, he's going to be very important going forward.
Floral Park, Brooklyn, New York native. Into the paint. A pass finds Ezekpe on the right side. He's nearly trapped out of bounds. Passes it, though. That one goes right through the hands of Adams Woods, who just lost it in between his hands. Josh Reed will come in following the UC turnover. Morgan Safford checks in for Julian Lewis. Lewis, a guy who's been held totally off the scoreboard in his 18 minutes tonight. Turned it over three times. It's been a tough night for Julian, who was in the starting lineup. Larry jogs across the timeline with it and hands to Mabry. Mabry works his way toward the middle. Little shimmy move. Announces it to Jaquel Morris. Now Larry found his way on the near side in an open look. Decided not to take it. Now drove into the top of the paint and punched in a two. 93-62, the lead that UC holds as they'll carry this one across the timeline. Switching from left to right hand is DeJulius. Ezekpe. Hip-high dribble. Hands it off for Skillings Jr., forces one through the paint. It's picked up and putting it over top of the basket there for UC. That might have been Jared Hensley. RedHawks going to go for an alley-oop on the other side. Morgan Safford couldn't get to it. It was tipped out of bounds by Hensley, who was guarding him. And so it'll stay Miami ball. Morgan Safford going to take a moment on the court to collect himself. As UC will bring on CJ Anthony. Columbus, Ohio native, all-time leading scorer in Central Ohio at a Harvest Prep High School, scored nearly 2,400 points. Off the inbound in the corner, the three-pointer is no good for Billy Smith. Quickly back out, Makai Leary tries a triple of his own, and he got it on the far wing. 16 points for Makai Leary, a couple of three balls to go with it. Under four to play, 93-65. UC with the lead, Skillings Jr. Two hands at top of the key for Josh Reed. Reed lunging, a pass over for Hensley, fakes, goes underneath in the paint, and a one-handed poster slam from Ezekpe.
Ezekpe has been a great spark plug guy off the bench for this UC team, excuse me, and has really been the kryptonite on the offensive end for Miami.
Ezekpe just delivered a slap there on the hands of Marambo as he was trying to pry that one away, but his slam ended a 7-0 run for the RedHawks. And the lead now back to 30 points at 95-65 as we've reached the final media timeout here in the second half. 3:29 to go in a 30-point game led by UC. We'll be back to Fifth Third Arena to close it out when we return here on RedHawk Radio. UC leads Miami with 3:29 to go here at Fifth Third Arena. Bearcats looking for a season high in points, just four away. Previous high was 98 in the game against Chaminade. Season opener for the Bearcats. Miami putting up a little more of a fight, a little bit closer in this one. Silver Swords lost that one 90. 88-55. RedHawks down 95-65. But UC has just continued to shoot the lights out tonight. 65% from the field, 58% from three, 11 for 19. 10 for 11 from the free throw line as well. Something that has plagued UC over the past couple of years. Looks like it may have been patched, as they're now 24 for their last 27 attempts at the charity stripe. Well, it's just been all-out dominance on the offensive side of the ball for the Bearcats. It's not as if Miami has been totally overmatched when they've had the ball. The turnovers have been an issue. We talked about that all game. 16 of them for the RedHawks in total.
Yeah, Luke, but, I think if you're looking at this from the Miami side, obviously this is a much more talented team that UC has. They've just got more recruiting. I mean, you look at this building they play in, it's no question whether they're getting better recruits, but I think you can actually be very happy with how Miami played. They put up a formidable fight tonight, and I think if you look at where Miami was when they first started the season to where they've come now, it's two completely different teams, and I think you're trending in the right direction towards MAC play.
Anderson Marambo going to shoot some free throws out of this timeout. He's 4 for 5 on the night. Only RedHawk player who's been at the free throw line more than once. This is now his fourth trip. First one rolls around and finds its way in. His lead dips under 30. It's just been an all-out dominant effort for UC on offense, but RedHawks have done okay for themselves when they've had the ball. Marambo drains the second. Kamari Williams will come back in for Miami. He will check in for Ryan Mabry. You know, this game really did feel like a Hail Mary in a three-game stretch for the RedHawks to beat UC, but you've got two very winnable games against quality opponents coming up against Bellarmine and Wright State over the next week. So UC carries this one across the timeline. Ezekpe at the free throw line. He lost it, dribbled on the court where Billy Smith scooped it up on the baseline, but a foul is called for the RedHawks on Makai Larry. That's his fourth. And the seventh team foul for the RedHawks means some free throws on the way for Kalu Ezekpe.
Yeah, and Luke, looking at the scoring breakdown for Miami away from these two foul shots for UC, it's the usual suspects. Larry has 16, Safford with 14. Mirabal now has 16 after those two free throws, and Billy Smith is a bucket away from 10 as well. So the same guys that were in double digits in that game in the previous game are the same four that are knocking on the door here.
First free throw is good from Ezekpe, Old Dominion transfer who averaged 11-7 points and rebounds in 4 years at ODU. He'll hit the second and immediately check out of the game. Sage Tolentino is in to the delight of this crowd. Tolentino, who played 1 year at Hamilton High School, 7'1" man out of Hawaii, played his final year of high school ball just down the road. RedHawks have it now back across the midcourt stripe. A pass intended for Morgan Safford was tipped away from him. He's able to recover it in the backcourt. He is closely guarded by Hensley. Two-handed to the far side. This is Larry trying to drive on people that are way taller than him. He puts up a formidable effort, and a foul will be called as he will head to the line to shoot two. Sage Tolentino out of Keneohe, Hawaii. Three-time state champ in the state before moving to Ohio, won a state championship as an eighth grader, was committed to Auburn originally, then decommitted during his season last year at Hamilton, wanted to play for Wes Miller, stay local. Larry rolls the first free throw around the rim and gets it to fall, 97-68, our score with 2:53 to go.
Tolentino, Hamilton grad now, also Hamilton boasts one of the Cincinnati greats, Joe Nuxhall, one of the guys that played at the super young age of 16 years old in the majors. Truly one of the special players in the MLB. Kind of cool Hamilton history, very sports rich area in Cincinnati. Cool that Tolentino's coming to play for the Bearcats.
Going for the poster dunk. Skillings Jr. blocked against the backboard now. Mabry up ahead for Kamari Williams. He'll put that one with the right hand into the bucket. 97-71 is our score with 2:29 to go. Is carrying across the timeline, CJ Anthony crossing back and forth on Makai Larry. Skillings Jr. now on the far wing, heads down to the baseline, rolls over a man, and a blocking foul is called as the ball rolls off the rim. No good. Foul will be on Kamari Williams. He'll pick up his third, eighth team foul for the RedHawks. 97-71 our score, 2:19 to go. And two free throws on the way for the 50% shooter in Dan Skillings.
Yeah, Luke, that was an interesting one. I'd have to see if we could get a replay where Kamari Williams' feet were there, because it seemed like he was plenty set, ready to go to take that charge, but I think might have had the feet in the cylinder on the court there, and obviously that's where you're going to get a block every time.
Two for two at the line is Skillings. 26-point lead for the Bearcats, 99-71, officially a season high in points for UC. Morris has it with his back turned to the basket. Hands to Williams, mows a man down. A blocking foul will be called on the flip side now as an acrobatic attempt at net will not go. CJ Anthony picks up his second. Miami enters the double bonus. That's a shooting foul, though, regardless. So it'll be two free throws for Kamari Williams. 81% shooter in his career for the RedHawks. And his first time at the line this season. His first appearance, first one rattles around the rim and falls off the front of it, no good. Second free throw, swish. 99-72. Hip high dribble for CJ Anthony as he crosses the midcourt stripe. Bounce pass to the far wing, Skillings Jr. into the flank, Tolentino back outside for CJ Anthony, who hauls it in. He one-hands it over to Hensley on the near side. Now this is Reed, cutting across, Reed in the paint. High left-handed look, that one rolls just off the rim, no good. Rebounded by the RedHawks, here comes Makai Larry. Crossing back and forth, looking for a pass into the near corner. There was a foul called before he could find it. Kind of a double pump there underneath the basket from Makai Larry before he eventually found Ryan Mabry, but that play was not allowed to go in its full continuation as there was a foul on Larry before that. He'll shoot two now at the line. 1:35 to go. 99-72 Bearcats lead on route to what's going to be their seventh win of the season. Larry hits the first.
And this is pretty much a perfect, picture-perfect game for Wes Miller. You get virtually everyone on your roster into this game now with some guys coming off the bench here at the free throw, one of them being a guy that we haven't seen yet this game. And you get pretty much everyone involved. You pick up an over 20-point victory and really a feel-good win coming off that tough rivalry loss against Xavier over the weekend.
Second free throw is good. Chase Kirkwood has entered the game for UC, a guy who was a manager at Arkansas, transferred to UC, was going to be a manager again and earned a roster spot in the summer. Unbelievable stuff from the Phoenix, Maryland native. Averaged nearly 20 points per game in high school. This is Tolentino working in the paint. He'll be fouled by Morris. To the delight of this crowd, they want to see him get on the board. But there are some pretty wild stories on as to how some of these guys found their way to UC when you just look up and down things. Kirkwood obviously grabbed some eyes. Tolentino with his whole story of playing in Hawaii and transferring in high school to play in Southwest Ohio. Tolentino, first free throw off the back iron. Bit of a groan from the crowd. You look at guys like Victor Lockin, who played for CSKA Moscow's two-team professional team in Russia. Of course, did not get paid for that. As Tolentino hits the second, and the crowd goes nuts.
If I'm not mistaken, Luke, I believe that's the first point of his UC career.
100 also for the Bearcats as they cross the mark into the triple digits. Larry down low, foul called. It'll be on Kirkwood. A blocking foul underneath the hoop as he was run over by Ryan Mabry. Official said the feet weren't set.
They've been consistent tonight. They've been loving the block, opposed to the charge. So that's really all you can ask for is consistency, and that's exactly what the refs have been tonight.
Looked like it was Mabry who was fouled. Now the RedHawks don't even know who it was. as Mabry and Larry. Larry was in the backcourt. Mabry was talking to Travis Steele. Neither guy knows who was fouled. They're both just standing at the free throw line now, and finally, it'll be Ryan Mabry, we learn, as Mekhi Larry makes his way back out into the backcourt. 1:05 to go. And Mabry will knock in the first. UC will be back in action against LaSalle on Saturday. It's the back end of the two shots as good as well from Ryan Mabry. They'll take on LaSalle here at Fifth Third, a 2 p.m. start, before Detroit Mercy comes to town on December 21st. Cutting to the basket, fed into the far corner. Three ball, got it. C.J. Anthony. With his first points of the season, as attempts from both three and attempts from the free throw line hasn't been able to hit him yet. But an exclamation mark on a feel-good night for the Bearcats. 103-76. Jaquel Morris drives in. It's stripped away by Josh Reed. He'll give to Anthony. Shot and game clock separated by one. Anthony dribbling this one at thigh height on the right. Now they're just going to turn the shot clock off at the request of the official, and that's going to do it. 103-76, an exclamation point victory for the UC Bearcats. And for the second straight year, this one's got a little more gusto. The Bearcats are going to beat the Miami RedHawks as the clock hits triple zero. UC improves to 7-4 on the season. Miami falls to 4-6. For the RedHawks, the tough slate continues with a matchup against the Knights from Bellarmine in Louisville at the Freedom Center on Saturday in a 4 p.m. start for UC. They'll be back in action against LaSalle here on Saturday at 2 p.m. in Clifton at Fifth Third. Zach, overall, not necessarily a performance you could be too disappointed about for the RedHawks. You face a team that is very good at shooting the basketball. That was clear coming into this one. That was even more clear, I think, at the end. And when things are all said and done, just got to be happy that you're able to come in and compete for a little bit of this game.
Yeah, you put up 76 points in this one. I think that's a good mark to have against a team that's also stout defensively. But realistically, you look at a team that across the way is shooting 63% from field goal and 60% from three. That's really not a game you're going to compete in often. That was similar to the mark we saw Marshall shoot from. And this team from UC is far more talented than the roster that Marshall has. So you come into Fifth Third Arena after what was a really close game in this rivalry last year. You put up a good showing. And even though it's a loss, I think you can still draw somewhat of a silver lining going into your last two games of non-conference play, starting with Bellarmine on Saturday.
Three players in double figures for the RedHawks. Mekhi Larry led the way with 20. Marambo with 16. Morgan Safford had 14 as well. For UC, two guys crossed the 20-point mark. Landers Nolly had the even at 20 points. And Victor Locken, or I beg your pardon, David DeJulius, had 22. As both those guys had hot shooting nights, both played 24 minutes before being taken off the floor. UC able to get a lot of guys into the game. 13 to be exact off the Cincinnati bench. A great win for Wes Miller and his group, as they'll have two more tune-ups before taking on Tulane just prior to New Year's to begin their final year in the AAC. Well, it's been a fun one here from Fifth Third Arena. We want to say thank you for tuning in. Thank you to the sports information staff at UC. This was a very last-minute broadcast that we threw together, so very appreciative of everyone at UC for helping us out. And it was a fun game from start to finish in an electric crowd here at Fifth Third Arena. So we'd like to say thank you for tuning in. Final score in this one, 103 points for UC, 76 for Miami. RedHawks back in action on Saturday. We'll carry that game in Louisville as the RedHawks take on the Bellarmine Knights. Until then, for Zach Rangers, our entire RedHawk radio crew, thanks for tuning in. RedHawks fall in this one. We'll see you next time. This is Luke West Poley saying so long and good night. Good night.